YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Today is December 21st, 2022. It's currently 6:33 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Here we got a view of the Old Faithful webcam looking out there at the Upper Geyser Basin. Yeah, interesting day today. I got three monitors that I downloaded. We got Little West Thumb, Holmes Hill, and Denny Creek. And I noticed that this earthquake right here showed up at Holmes Hill really good. At Denny Creek, it was just like a little blip. And it didn't show up here on Little West Thumb. I thought, that's really strange. Why did this earthquake show up so well at one site? And it's a strong signature, and not at the others. Well, I found out why, which raises more questions. There was a magnitude 5.2 earthquake there. Revilla Gigado. Yeah, I know I'm pronouncing that wrong. Yeah, butcher another name. Okay, let me show you on Google Earth where it's at. It was along the Riviera Plate. Over here we got Mexico. And let me zoom in. And yeah, you can see this trench. Yeah, so this plate is doing a clockwise rotation as it moves under and subducts under this part of the North American plate. Yeah, North American plate's been really moving lately. That magnitude 6.4 earthquake off the coast there of California, yeah, that was caused by the movement of the North American plate moving west. Now, they have no moment tensor ball for this 5.2, but I assume because this is the Riviera plate, it was caused by subduction going underneath the North American plate, not where the North American plate was moving southwest. Another interesting fact, a lot of you know, is that the plume going up to Yellowstone actually comes from this area. Yep, all the way up here from the Gulf of California, it travels all the way up to Yellowstone. So I thought that was interesting. Now here we have the ANSS helioplots. And right there's that earthquake as it came in to Albuquerque, New Mexico. Let me click on that and make that a little bit bigger. If it'll let me, it's taking its time in loading. There we go. Let me bring it over. And you can look at the time when it came in there. All right, let me go back. And we'll look at some of these other ones. Okay, this one here, it came in later. That was Missouri. Cathedral Caves, Missouri. Alaska does not show up. Corvallis, Oregon comes in later. Came in later for Disney Wilderness Preserve. That's there at the park. Hockey, Texas. Let me make that one bigger. So looking at the time frame and how soon or how later it came in, there's Hawaii. Let me show you Hawaii right there. And you can look at the time when it came in there at Hawaii. So Holmes Hill, let me go to Holmes Hill on the map because that was actually the strongest signature. We'll go to Google Earth. You know, and Denny Creek is fairly close to Holmes Hill. And Little West, oops, there's Little West Thumb. I did not want to make that bigger. I can make it bigger here for Holmes Hill. And then I'll make it bigger for you for Denny Creek. Yeah, see how it's just a little blip. We'll get into the screaming. Yeah, there's been screaming. I'll show you that real quick. Look at that. Yeah, we'll cover that in a minute. Yep. All right, going to Google Earth. Here we have Hedgen Lake. This here is the monitor for Holmes Hill. Down over here is Little West Thumb, where it does not show up at. Let me go back over here and show you Denny Creek, which is over here. So the strongest signature was actually up in this location. Is that again? No, that's Maple Creek. I couldn't get that one to download. Okay, right there, Holmes Hill. Now, this is the area where we've been having the earthquake swarm. So I thought that was very interesting that the monitor at Little West Thumb didn't show the signature. Denny Creek, which would actually be closer to the area there down by Mexico, shows it, but only as a blip. But this area that is more active in earthquakes, that was a definite show. So the monitor on the left, that is Little West Thumb. Middle is Holmes Hill and Denny Creek. And then let me go up farther because let me show you this one too. You're probably saying, wow. You know what earthquake that is? That's the earthquake that occurred in California. That's that 6.4. And it showed up at Holmes Hill, the greatest, compared to Little West Thumb or Denny Creek. All right, so I clicked on each of the time frames. And let me make Denny Creek bigger, because this is a real interesting signature from that earthquake in California. Yeah, look how it shook up the caldera. Let me pull this over and you can see this. It's like, wow. Okay. Now, these are pockets of melt, and I've talked about that, and that's been in the news lately, how the melt there at Yellowstone is, these pockets is actually larger than what they've been trying to convince us, anywhere between 15 to 20% melt. Yeah, they used to say it was like 5% melt, maybe 10. And now we find out that the melt is actually greater, and they figured that for Yellowstone to erupt, they would need, let me pull this up, 30% melt. When the crystals get hot, it, it melts. It allows the magma to flow up through the dikes and the tubes much easier. It's kind of like using PAM spray, to lubricate for the lava, which is called magma when it's still under the ground. So let's bring this over because it showed up really good here at Holmes Hill. Yeah, this would be heated water and gases right here. But see the magma at the bottom where it does not show up on the other monitors. Again, this is the area where they've been having the earthquake swarms. And then it slowly settled down. And I'll bring it over. Let's look at the earthquake signature. Let me extract that right there. This is when it was settling down. Oh, you can't really tell that. Let's go to the beginning. All right, yeah, see rounded tops. I've talked about this. This is when you got magma on the move. This is called volcanic tremors. Harmonic tremors. Harmonic tremors are actually smaller. But this is volcanic tremors. This is when magma is on the move. And then we got some other ones here. We got a small one which ended up being even smaller. And let's bring this down. Let me bring this down. Okay, and let's take a look what it was showing when I pulled the files earlier. Yeah, they kind of sharpen points, so that would be tectonic in nature. And let me bring this over here to this one. Yeah, tectonic. This is when either the fault has moved or we got the North American plate moving. All right, so let's go back to Denny Creek. I'll make that one bigger because I've talked about the magma coming up there. Look at that. Look at that in the line of melt. Yep. And right there, it sort of screamed, not really, but a little bit. And you can see them all marked in red. There's a lot of them here. And we'll pull this down. And yeah, there's all kinds of them. Yep. And down over here. Look at that. Let me bring this down so you can see it. Might hear some noises in the background. My grandson is here on his tablet. Yep, over there and there. And this is what it was showing when I pulled the files. Look at this. It's like, wow. Boom, boom, boom. Yep, popping. Let me look at the seismic signature. Okay, and we'll go to this one here. That's a little bit smaller. Or did my thing go small on me? Hard to tell. Yeah, smaller. You can see how we don't have as much gases. And then that one's marked in red. Boom, more popping. The ground, the pressure is coming up. Making the ground very brittle, like glass. The magma has been moving horizontally. Those of you that have been following me for a while will know that it's got a cap of rhyolite, which keeps the magma under pressure. One day it's going to go boom. But because it's got the cap, it's been moving horizontally. This monitor here is Little West Thumb of Yellowstone Lake, down there where they got Grant, the campground of Grant. Yeah, look at that, marked in red. Okay, and the reports of earthquakes that USGS is telling us about is 10 for the last week. The most recent was today, a magnitude, let's see, 2.1 at 4:48 Universal Time, and that would be down there by Heart Lake. And again, for those of you that have followed me, you know that when Yellowstone had its last major eruption, it did an unzipping. Boom, 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 boom. Counterclockwise, it started up here in the Madison River area, unzipped, you know, explosion after explosion until it got down here by Heart Lake. And then when it did that, both resurgent domes, the Sour Creek resurgent dome, which is up over here, if you can see where my little pointer's at, and then the Mallard Lake resurgent dome, which is where the live webcam is at, both collapsed at the same time, and that's when Yellowstone blew. So the most recent, a 2.1 and a 2.0. Okay, both 4:48 and 4:20 Universal Time. So let's see if I can find this. Okay, this one is 17:05. All right, again, the only monitor it really shows up on is Holmes Hill that I got to download. Yeah, many of the monitors I could not get to work. All right, so we have one here at 4:20. Okay. And 4:49. So Holmes Hill is quite a ways away. Okay, the 2.1 at 4:48 and 53 seconds. Way down here in the monitor that does show it, which is really strange that only one monitor would show it for a 2.1. And, you know, they said years ago when they started having magnitude 2 earthquakes, they would be concerned. I come up with a magnitude 2.29. USGS said it was a 2.1. So, all right, let's go to this one. Okay, that one definitely looks bigger. All right, so they are reporting it, and they're saying it's a 2.0, but it looks bigger to me. You can look at the seismic signature. Yeah, and they're same location where they happened down there by Heart Lake. This one definitely is not a 2.0. This one comes in as a magnitude 2.92. It could possibly even be a 3, but I gave them the benefit of the doubt, going by the seismic signature and how long it rattled on. Yeah, I ended it right there. It should have been a little bit longer, but... So once again, the earthquakes are showing up better at Holmes Hill than they are at any other place. And again, this is Madison River, yeah, where they've been having all the earthquake swarms. I do not see the screaming. Let's go back to, let's see here. Let me pull this up. I already did Denny Creek, showed you the screaming there. Let's go to Little West Thumb. There at Yellowstone Lake. Yeah, I already showed you that. And let's see what it was showing when I pulled the files. Okay. I really don't see any screaming here either. Let me close this. Well, actually, this is when I pulled the files, and we'll just look at the signature. Yeah, got some drum beats going on. Tectonic. This is all tectonic movement. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, but I do not see any screaming. Nope, and it's hard to tell. But, nope, I don't see it. Let's go here. Yeah. Someone here on YouTube was watching the camera this morning. I was not home this morning. I went shopping. Had to get some eggs and stuff from the store. Wanted to get them while they came in, when the truck came in. But they said that the smoke, the steam coming up from the geysers looked dirty today. Again, this is Denny Creek. Yeah, the Madison River area. Getting darker now. It's now 7:02 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Yeah, we got some really cold weather. It's supposed to be down 55 to 60 below zero where I'm at. I'm prepared. I'm used to this stuff. Yeah. Yeah, but a lot of people aren't. A lot of people don't prepare. So it kind of looks like it's snowing there. I hope everyone else is prepared. They do what they can and get ready for this cold. They were giving us health warnings about only staying outside for about 5 minutes. Anything longer, you could get frostbite on your face and hands. And yeah, right now it's supposed to be -2 degrees there, and it's supposed to get down to -34 degrees there, and that is not with the wind chill. And supposedly with the wind chill, it's -14 right now. Supposedly gonna be -18 with the wind chill later tonight, but I think it's gonna be much colder. Anyways, that's all I have for you right now. I really appreciate you guys watching. I really appreciate your support. A lot of people can't do that like they did before because the economy is bad and it's going to get worse. Next year is going to be worse than what it is this year, and you guys need to be prepared. Think of yourselves and think of your family first. Always think of them first. Once again, thank you very much. Have a Merry Christmas, and God bless you all. Thank you. Bye.